This is an alternate setup for standing ankle inversion pails and rails using a slant board. If you'd like to pick up a slant board, just refer to our resources section where we have them there for you. So what you're going to do to set this up is you're going to have the outside of your foot along this barrier here, so you don't slide out of it. And you're going to take your other foot and you're going to step away from the ankle that's being trained. So I don't want to just keep stepping out further this way. I want to think about shifting my hips away from that ankle, keeping my foot flat on that slant board to allow me to get a good stretch along the outside of that ankle. Okay, so you're gonna hang out in this stretch for about 2 minutes, taking deep, slow, relaxing breaths, trying to slowly create more of a stretch as you relax, getting deeper into that outer ankle inversion stretch, okay? From there, you're gonna take a breath in, brace that core, and then you're gonna slowly start ramping up that contraction, pressing the inside of your foot down. So you're using these muscles here to create more of an inversion rotation, or an eversion rotation, I should say. Building that contraction up for 10 seconds, holding that maximum contraction for another 10 seconds. So you have a 20 second total pails contraction, and then your rails contraction is trying to create more inversion by trying to lift the inside of my foot off of the slant board. Okay, so now I'm contracting everything on the inside, I'm creating more of a stretch on the outside of that ankle. I'm going right into that contraction for about 15 seconds. Once I'm done there, I can relax, I can shift more into that stretch position, and you can repeat 1 to 2 more times before you switch ankles. So that is standing ankle inversion pails and rails using a slant board.